We have derived an algorithm for LU factorization, and we have linked that to the algorithm for Gaussian elimination, showing that they are equivalent. But something interesting comes up along the way, obviously. What if we divide by zero? In other words, what if the diagonal element that shows up along the way is ever equal to zero? So that brings up the question, under what circumstances will this algorithm complete? And is it only under those circumstances that the algorithm will complete? And that's what we're going to look at next. So here is a theorem about the existence of the LU factorization. Okay? If we're given a matrix A, where that matrix is n by n, so now we're going to talk about an LU factorization of a rectangular matrix, not necessarily just a square matrix. M is greater than or equal to n, so fewer columns than rows, or at most as many columns as rows, with linearly independent columns, then A has a unique LU factorization if and only if all of its principal leading submatrices are non-singular. Okay, now there's two things we need to talk about. Number one, what does it even mean to compute an LU factorization of a non-square matrix? Because now L can't be a lower triangular matrix. So here we have A is equal to L times U. If A is rectangular, then it will have a shape sort of like that. And if that's equal to L times U, then L has the same number of columns and U is upper triangular. Hey, where have we seen that before? We've seen that when we did the QR factorization, right? And then this particular matrix is actually, we probably should call it lower trapezoidal. Okay, where all of these entries are equal to zero, all of these entries are equal to zero, and the entries on the diagonal are all equal to one. Okay, the second thing we need to talk about is, what is a principal leading submatrix? A principal leading submatrix, well, we're really good at partitioning matrices now. So if you take your matrix A and you partition it into quadrants, and this top left quadrant is square, then it's called a principal leading submatrix. Okay? And what has to be the case is that the principal leading submatrix is non-singular no matter what size you pick it. All right? So now we have figured out what all the parts of this theorem are, and now we need to prove it. Now it turns out that proving that if A has an LU factorization, that then its leading submatrices must be non-singular, that's relatively straightforward. So I'll just let you read the proof for that, or you may want to try to do that on your own. The part where if all of its principal leading submatrices are non-singular, that then A has a unique LU factorization, that's a little bit harder. Now, anytime you run into something like this, your instinct should be, maybe we should do this through a proof by induction. And then you have to ask the question, proof by induction on what? Because we could do a proof by induction on M or a proof by induction on N. And I'll give you the hint that you should do a proof by induction on N. Okay, now, with that hint, you may actually want to try to go and do the proof yourself and then come back to how we do it. But you may also just want to move on to the next video.